Now we'll see next problem. A stone is rotated steadily in a horizontal circle with time period T by a string of length L. If the tension in a string is kept constant and L increases by 1%, what is the percentage change in time period? So basically you have to calculate the percentage change in time period if the length L of a string is increased by 1%. So first we will draw the figure pertaining to this problem. And the string is rotated in a horizontal circle. This is y-axis, this is our x-axis, and this is z-axis. The string is rotated in xz plane. So the length of a string is m, the length of a string is l, and a mass m is attached to it, and time period will be given by t. Now as we know that when a body is rotated in a circular path, then it requires centripetal force, and that centripetal force in this case will be tension T in a string. So this is tension T in a string, which is equal to centripetal force. So tension is equal to Fc, that is centripetal force, and as we know that Fc is equal to m omega square r. Here r is equal to L, which is the length of a string, so m omega square L. Now you have to calculate the percentage change in time period. So the formula should be written in terms of time period. As we know that omega is equal to 2 pi by t, omega is equal to 2 pi by t, where omega is the angular velocity and t is the time period. Then if I put omega is equal to 2 pi by t here, then Fc is equal to m into 4 pi square L divided by t square, and it is equal to tension in the string. So tension is equal to Fc is equal to m 4 pi square L by t square, where t is the time period. Now we increase the length of the string without changing the tension. So basically in this equation, tension, mass m, and this 4 pi square remains constant. So we may write that T square is directly proportional to L, where L is the length of a string, or T is directly proportional to L to the power 1 by 2. Now as we have already learned in the error chapter, that if K is a form of A to the power X, or K is directly proportional to A to the power X, then percentage change in K is equal to x into percentage change in A. So here if we apply this formula, then percentage change in T is equal to 1 by 2 into percentage change in L. So here the percentage change in L is equal to 1%. So the percentage change in time period T will be 0.5%. So answer will be 0.5%, which is B. Now we will see next problem, and this problem says that if mass, speed and radius of rotation of a body moving in a circular path all increased by 50%, then the necessary force required to maintain the body moving in circular path will be increased by. So basically here also, a body of mass m is attached to a string having length L, and it is rotated in a circular path having angular speed equal to omega with linear velocity equal to v. So you have to calculate that all things, the mass, speed and length, all three parameters has been increased by 50%. So first we will calculate the tension in the string, or the necessary centripetal force in the string, which is equal to mv square by L. Now speed has been increased by, so if I put equal to mv square. Now if we increase the mass, speed and radius by 50%, then the new force will be equal to Fc1 is equal to m1 v1 square by l1. So here m1 is equal to 3 by 2 m, v1 is equal to 3 by 2 v, and l1 is equal to 3 by 2 l. Then the force will be changed from fc to fc1. Now if we solve it, then it's come equal to 9 by 4 m v square by l, or 9 by 4 into f. So fc1 or necessary centripetal force will be 9 by 4 times the earlier centripetal force. So you have to calculate the change in force, and in fact you have to calculate the percentage change in force required. So percentage change, first we will calculate the change in force. So change in force is equal to 9 by 4 f minus f, and it is equal to 5 f by 4, and percentage change is equal to 5 f by 4 divided by f into 100, and it is equal to 5 by 4 into 100, it is equal to 125%. So the necessary force required to maintain the body moving in a circular path will have to be increased by 125%. So all these problems are not that much tough. You just need to understand the basic concept inside the problem. Again, this is our next problem, that two masses M and capital M are connected by a light string that passes through a smooth hole O at the center of a table. Mass M lies on the table and capital M hangs vertically. M is moving around in a horizontal circle with O as the center. If L is the length of a string from O to M, and then the frequency with which M should revolve so that the mass M remains stationary. So see, if you see this figure, then what this figure says, that this body of mass small m is moving in a circle such that a bigger mass capital M is connected, is attached to it, and if this smaller mass rotates in this way, then this capital M mass remains stationary at its position. So how it possible? See, if I draw the free body diagram of this capital M mass, then in the downward direction it has one force mg, while in the upward direction it is having tension T. So for this mass to be in stationary, that T minus mg is equal to 0 and T is equal to mg. So whenever the tension T will be equal to mg, then this bigger mass will remain in, or the mass capital M will remain in stationary. So this tension will be given by the tension due to this centripetal force. So as smaller mass moves in a circle having radius equal to L, then the necessary centripetal force is equal to mv square by L, and you have to calculate the frequency. So for calculation of frequency, you just derive the formula in terms of frequency. So fc is equal to m omega square l, and it is equal to m into 2 pi n square into l, where n is the frequency. So m into 4 pi square n square into l. So this is our necessary centripetal force, and it should be equal to tension T. So mg is equal to m l into 4 pi square n square. So n square is equal to mg by m l into 1 by 4 pi square. And if I put the if I take the square root on both sides, then the value comes equal to n is equal to 1 by 2 pi square root mg by ml. So if the smaller mass small m moves with a frequency n which is given by this equation in a circle of radius l, then the mass having the capital M mass will remain in stationary position. So answer will be A, and frequency will be 1 by 2 pi square root capital mg divided by small m into l. So this is our next problem. A gramophone record is revolving with an angular velocity omega. A coin is placed at a distance r from the center of record. The static coefficient of friction is mu. The coin will revolve with a record if, and the four conditions are given. So basically this is our gramophone record, and a coin is placed at a distance r from it. So here coin is placed. Now this revolves with a angular speed with angular velocity omega. So this small coin will rotate in a circle having radius equal to r and with angular velocity omega. So when the coin will not be thrown off, or the coin will revolve with the record when the static coefficient or the static friction will be equal to the necessary centrifugal force in this case. So as the body is rotating in a rotating frame of reference, so we will consider the net force in this case. So here the necessary centrifugal force will be equal to mv square by r, or m omega square into r. We are considering that the observer is also at the gramophone and rotating with an angular velocity equal to omega. If we consider as a stationary observer sitting here, then for him the necessary centripetal force will be provided by this by the frictional force, which is equal to mu mg. And because of this necessary centripetal force, the coin will revolve with the record. And while if we consider the observer also rotating with the gramophone, then it will consider this force as a centrifugal force. So we may write that if friction is equal to m omega square r for the limiting case, that is when it will just be able to rotate, and mu mg is equal to m omega square r. So whenever mu mg force will be less than or equal to m omega square r, in fact when the mu mg will be greater than, when the mu mg force is the necessary centripetal force, so whenever this force will be more than the required centripetal force, then the body will be able to revolve. Whenever this friction force will not be able to provide the necessary centripetal force, then the body will be thrown off. So our condition will must be that the frictional force must be equal to or greater than the necessary centripetal force for the body to revolve with the record. So whenever this force will become less than our necessary centripetal force, then the body will not be able to rotate. So mu mg must be greater than m omega square r, and from there we get that omega square r is less than equal to mu g, and r is less than equal to mu g by omega square. So answer will be first. This is the last problem based on this concept, and this is the very good problem in fact, that a particle p of mass m is attached to a vertical axis by two string AP and BP of length LH, and the separation AB is equal to L. P rotates around the axis with angular velocity equal to omega. The tension in two strings are T1 and T2. Then four statements are given, and you have to identify that which statement is correct. So first we will redraw this figure here, and then we will solve it. So basically this is the particle P, and its mass is equal to m. Here it's a tension T1 and if you consider the tension in this string will be T2. This is the length L, and this mass is rotating in this circle. You have to calculate, so whenever this mass comes at this place, the tension will be T1 and T2. So you have to calculate the value of you have to calculate basically the value of T1 and T2, and then see that which of the following statements are correct. So if L is this length, L is this length, and L is also this length, then this will be at the center and this length will be L by 2. So this angle comes equal to 30 degrees. So now I just redraw figure again, that here tension T1, here mass M, and it is at tension T2, and both tension are it's making an angle 30 degrees. Here also it is making an angle 30 degrees. Now if we draw the free body diagram on this mass, then it will have one force equal to T1 sin theta in upward direction and T2 sin theta in downward direction, where theta is equal to 30 degrees. Again, in downward direction the body will have a force equal to its weight, that is mg, and if we see in the horizontal direction, then it will have force T1 cos theta plus T2 cos theta. And so basically, as per this figure, this force, if we equate the force in the along y axis or in the vertical direction, then we will get T1 sin theta is equal to T2 sin theta plus mg, and T1 minus T2 sin theta is equal to 1 by 2 here is equal to mg, and T1 minus T2 is equal to twice mg. So this is our first equation, which is T1 minus T2 is equal to 2 mg. So answer B will be correct. So first answer will be B. Now if we see the motion along the horizontal axis, then T1 cos theta plus T2 cos theta will provide the necessary centripetal force. So if we consider the equations along x axis, then T1 cos theta plus T2 cos theta is equal to m omega square into L cos 30 degrees, because the particle is moving in a circle having radius equal to L cos 30 degrees. If this is the length L, then the radius of circle in which particle is moving is L cos 30 degrees. So T1 plus T2 into cos 30 degrees is equal to m omega square into L cos 30 degrees. So the value comes equal to T1 plus T2 is equal to m omega square into L. So T1 plus T2 is equal to m omega square L. So answer C and B both are correct. Now we will calculate now that the value of T1 and T2 and say that whether the answer in the options given in D will be correct or not. So from this, T1 plus T2 is equal to m square L, and T1 minus T2 is equal to 2 mg. You have to calculate the value of T2 and check that whether VP will remain taut only for omega greater than square root 2 GL or not. So you have to calculate T2. So if we do 1 minus 2, if this is our equation 1, this is our equation 2, then if you do 1 minus 2, then we get 2T2 is equal to m omega square L minus, here is 2, minus 2 mg, and T2 is equal to T2 is equal to 1 by 2 m omega square L minus 2g. So T2 will remain taut, or the string will remain taut if T2 will be greater than 0. So whenever T2 greater than 0, then the string will remain taut or string will not slack. So in this case, omega square L minus 2g must be greater than equal to 0, and omega square L must be greater than equal to 2g, and omega must be greater than equal to square root 2g by L. So whenever omega or the angular velocity will be greater than square root 2g by L, then the second string, that BP, will also be in taut and it will not slack. Whenever the value of omega becomes less than square root 2g by L, then this string will slack. So this answer D is also correct. So basically here answer B, C, D all are correct for this problem.